These guys are going. A little bit of information here about the tender. As you can see, he is on one side of the wall. He is unable to help other than hand out the brick, lay them down. He cannot hand the brick. The mason will be grabbing the brick and he will go from there. All right, I think we'll be talking about our competitors. You can see that they have their starter course going, and he is already on his way by. See the tender's lining up the brick in the format in which the bricklayer prefers to have his brick. Patient up, building his wall all the way across here, folks. 80 these brick overhanded. As if they were on the actual wall or scaffolding itself. You'll see as this bricklayer, all talent, folks. These guys are getting after it and they are not hesitating. Going.
Bricklayer 500 here in Dallas, North Texas edition, our regional. And we appreciate you guys watching. We appreciate our sponsors, obviously. We appreciate our regional and our national sponsors, all the bricklayers that came out, and all of our sponsors that brought their tents here today. This is an international competition, and we've got like 20 regional or more regionals, and then we have international people that come in and all try to compete to go and win in Vegas. It's a great event. SPEC MIX does this to try to promote masonry industry and also to promote the masons and give them support. So it's a lot of fun. It's a little bit watered down this year, quite a bit watered down, just like Tulsa was because of COVID, trying to follow all the rules and regulations of that. And we've got hand washing stations and signs and social distancing. We've provided a bunch of SPEC MIX masks. So it's gonna be a little bit different this year, but we're having fun. So let James run around and show you some more stuff. And we'll get back to rules, we'll get back to strategy, we'll get back to showing you walls and whatnot here in a little while.
All right, Robert, thank you very much for that little introduction there. We're gonna walk around a little bit and show you as if you were right here with one of these guys checking this event out. And if you're a mason out there and you wanna participate in these events, look us up at specmix.com or on Facebook, under SPEC MIX. It's Grand Prairie High School right here. This is an instructor, along with one of the students, as his tender. These guys are here to represent Grand Prairie High School. Doing an awesome job for us. We appreciate those guys coming here. Little information here on this particular team is that Kevin, he's about to become the voice of the masonry programs here in Texas, which is a brand new position that we're doing in Texas. Kevin's gonna be going around and he's gonna be talking to instructors on fundamentals of masonry, getting their masonry program started, getting students involved with contractors so that they have those jobs that they need after school, and of course, growing the masonry industry. Kevin, not only just a tender, he's a bricklayer and he'll be competing in other bricklayer events. Robert McKibben, one of the teachers at Grand Prairie in our carpentry program, doing a fantastic job here for us and is looking to extend the education of others in our public school system. So honored to have these two guys here doing what they do. And man, I just can't say enough good about these guys in a sense of what they're doing to the masonry industry. Look forward to seeing what his wall looks like first time. And we'll be checking in back with these guys very soon. This is Richard Salinas in this next group right here with DMG Masonry. As you can see, nice start to the bricklayer event. The man, the myth, the legend, 70-year-old tender right here, yes?
Yeah.
Awesome, incredible. So if you're out there and you think you're not gonna be able to do this or can't do this or don't wanna start a career in the masonry industry, look again, folks. This man has got it going on. Excited to have you here. Take a look here at Shelby Royson. He's got it going here. Got some nice looking leads. Keep in mind, these guys are here to lay brick, keep it plumb, keep it straight. They'll be given an opportunity towards the end of the bricklaying to come back, clean their walls up, take a little break, fix any imperfections, and then we'll do our judging at the end of that. We're probably only about 10 minutes into that. We'll do our very best to stay away from these guys so that we don't distract too much, but they're excited to be here, excited to be on camera, excited to be showing their talents off to the world. There you go. Shout out to Oklahoma. Talking to Shelby a little earlier, and something surprising to me is that his wife, Rebecca, don't see her here right now, but he says that she's a dang good bricklayer, stone layer, and can do it, and we're looking forward to seeing if we can get her out here next year.
She'll be next year.
She'll be here. All right. We'll be looking for it. Again, that's a man right there, proud of his wife, proud of his team, proud of his company, right out of Oklahoma. We appreciate you guys being here. You can see Jimmy's keeping his brick lined up the way that he prefers to get them. You'll see that he's tossed a couple of brick around, and these guys are deducted for various chips in brick more than a quarter inch, so he's doing his very best to make sure the brick he gets or gets handed off from his tender is ready to be put in the wall and judged properly. Get some views from the side of this bin here. If it looks like these guys are hustling, that's because they are. They are doing the job that they need to do to win the event. And Bobby Simpson and his tender here, Brandon. It's their third time to compete. Says he's gonna win. Make the checkout in his name, he says. So far, so good. Got a nice looking wall. Strings are nice and tight. A little bit about some of the tools of the trade here. You see these guys are using these blocks with strings and our trigs. These are spec mix trigs, as you'll see, and they line these in the wall, and as they build their walls up and their leads up, they'll put a brick to keep that string nice and taut so they know exactly what they're doing. We're proud to be able to hand these tricks of the trade out to these folks. Spec Mix is a proud donor of these twigs to these guys.
Stacking them too high, Brandon.
Yes, sir.
Too high for now. You'll go higher here.
Teams are talking, visiting with each other. Whitehead Masonry here getting a good start. D. Brown doing a nice job. Former winner, former contestant in Vegas. We're gonna walk over here with Robert, talk about some of our national sponsors real quickly, and we'll get you right back to the event.
Hey, James, appreciate you coming by. Something we just wanted to talk about, we'll talk about it throughout the event, is our sponsors, our national sponsors, and our regional sponsors are huge. And so just a couple of them that we kind of want to go over is Marshalltown. They've supported the Bricklayer 500 since 2003, since the start. And they make great trowel, they make some other products, but they are one of the biggest supporters of the training programs here in the U.S. for our masons, so we really appreciate them. Still, of course, they're out here every year here at Nationals. We really appreciate all they do. They've got some great saws, cutoff saws, new Rock Boss. Masonry saw still makes tools that last for years. You'll see them out on the job site. They're forever almost. So they've been a sponsor for the last 15 years. So we really appreciate them. Blackletter out of Sweden, actually. They make work clothes. You'll see the Blackletter pants on all the Masons at the Nationals. But they make shirts, hats, and t-shirts, and all kinds of clothes for the work industry. So just wanted to just let you know that.
Thanks, Robert. We're going to get back to the bricklaying here. keep these folks interested in what we got going on here. As you can see, they are hustling. They're only about 15 to 20 minutes into this, and there is a pace to beat, that is for sure. Justin Pierce here with some nice walls again. Again, Lupe, former winner here.
White shirt, he's dealing with Artisan Masonry. He's the boss man, superintendent.
Quick little bio here on Lupe, and I won't distract him too much from what he's doing because we know that he wants to get this wall up and he wants to be a contestant for one of the winners here. But Lupe, not only just a bricklayer, guys, this gentleman here, he's an instructor at North Lake Campus here in Dallas as far as teaching the programs at the PMC. He is not only doing his part to be one of the better bricklayers here and show folks what it's about, but he's teaching our youth, he's teaching adults, teaching the apprentice program, and it looks like, man, if he was my teacher, I couldn't say anything bad about it, that's for sure. Certainly looks like he knows what he's got going on. You see, he's laying his mud. Preparation to come back, put his brick down at a half inch mortar joint, keep it level with the strings, and we've got the crowd, yes?
Yeah.
All right.
What you doing over there?
We're here for a brick challenge. Picking up and see you using this Stabila Level. Close, folks. He did twice in Vegas, folks. Jose Waffo. Our very best not to disrupt. Nice and tight and level. And again, the height he needs to. The brick. We're looking for. In here. No, my phone is not going in fast motion, folks. This is normal speed as far as recording, but not normal bricklaying speed. Excellent job. Not his first time doing this, that's for sure. You see he's moving his strings up to keep his next line straight along with the string. Using the SPEC MIX line blocks. We appreciate him using that. I'm gonna get out of Skytrack's way here. We appreciate our mud slingers here doing the job they're doing to get the mud out to their masons. We're gonna kind of stand back here a little bit so you can get a kind of a picture of what the event's going on. Get a broader view of the happenings of the event. Shout out to a lot of our local competitors here. As you'll see, we'll, from time to time, we'll talk about these competitors here, these sponsors, rather, in a few minutes. But we're gonna stand here and watch who's here to compete, and that'll be these guys right here. Again, these guys will be going to Vegas, folks. We take one of the winners here, the first place winner. Typically, at the first of the year, they go to the World of Concrete, but this year, the World of Concrete's moved to the middle of the summer, so we're gonna be taking one winner here to Vegas to compete to win an F-250 Ford pickup truck along with lots and lots of other prizes and cash. We'll keep it moving here. Thank you. take a look at some of the folks that's got a nice lead going. When I say lead, meaning courses, we count the courses of brick, folks. 80 brick per course. A little styling technique here. As you can see, his tender has his brick laid at an angle, which is the way the mason prefers to have it. This way he knows that the brick are to be faced inward versus out. Of course, if they turn the brick out, that would count as an adduction. So these guys are well aware of that, and they're competing, and he's lining the brick up so that he knows that when he grabs that brick and puts it down, that there are no opportunities for misplacement. Got a good looking wall here, consisting of about 10 courses of brick. Looking good. No stranger to laying brick, folks, that's for sure. We'll keep an eye on this competitor here. These walls are looking really, really good. Artisan Masonry, big supporter of our bricklayer events. We appreciate him being here. And Jose, he's competed five times, twice in Vegas. And as you can see from his wall, no wonder he's done that, folks. We'll get back to him. Do a little visiting on this wall as time goes on. Looking walls, tenders working hard. Nobody's sweating here. Let's go over here and visit with Robert, let him tell us a little bit about what he's seeing. Robert, what are you seeing here on these walls?
Well, I'm just looking at the different kinds of strategies. We had done this last week. I'm Robert Gleason from Houston, if you hadn't talked to us or seen us here in a while. Anyway, we're talking about some of the strategies they do on the wall. So, the leads here are the most important part of the wall. They got to build these the right height and plumb, or they got to build them the right height and plumb, or you're not going to have a great wall. So really have to work on that. The other thing is the mortar joints and the thicknesses, sizes. But if this isn't done right, then the whole wall will be incorrect. And just like on a house, you start from two corners and you go to the middle. And if this end and that end are right, you're in good shape. So that's one of the big strategies, is having a proper lead. So another one is where you put the boards in relationship to the wall. And so some guys put them real close, some guys don't. A lot of the guys I see now, they elevate their mud boards right here. You see over here to the right, to your left. They elevate the mud boards so that they don't have to reach down as far to get it done.
Some of the tricks of the trade right here, folks. That's the elevation of the board, so they're less leaning. Every second counts, as you can tell.
And also the angle. So depending on which way the guys, they may work it up and down the wall, depends on how his tender lays out his bricks. This way or that way. And so it's all a matter of seconds. It makes a huge difference in strategy. There's a bunch of other strategies out there. We really don't want to go over those because they're sort of secret. But I just wanted to cover a few of them for you. I'm going to go over the rules here in about another 15, 20 minutes.
Thank you, Robert. Again, Robert walking around, giving us some commentary here. Take a little peek at Bobby Simpson here. Third time to compete. Comes from a family of masons. And something a little unusual here in this part of the world, loggers. Loggers and masons. We'll take the masonry world any day. But we appreciate the loggers as well. You can see again some of the strategy of the tender is to put the brick the way that the mason wants them. Keep it in stacked appropriately, turned all one way. Mason doesn't want to have to worry about what brick he grabs, whether it's good or bad. He knows it's ready to go and it's good for laying. Take another peek at Artisan's wall here. As you can see, one of the strategies here, she's laying one side of the wall. comes back, fills it in. This is what you would call an extreme competent bricklayer, meaning he's laid one side of the wall knowing that if the event were over right now, that wouldn't count. But he's coming back, filling it in because he knows he's going to, he knows he can do it. Serious competitor and winner of previous bricklayer events, looking to go to Vegas one more time. Good job, guys. Looking real good. We'll walk over here and check on some of our folks on this side of the competition court. Again, our teacher and student getting after it. First time to compete, doing an excellent job. Fantastic walls. We're looking to see some great things out of these guys. Again, as I mentioned, tender here, Kevin. Working with our masonry programs here in Texas. Gonna go around to all the high schools, instruct carpentry teachers the proper techniques of masonry and get them started and to kick it off in a good way. We appreciate all the efforts that he's doing. Get in here and watch these guys do a little bit of work. DMG here, appreciate you guys being here. These guys show up, they bring their tools. They use their own tools, follow the rules, and hope to win some new tools. You future masons and tenders out there, this is the event to be in. We want to see you here. We do these regionally across the United States for one winner of each region, each event, to compete and go to Vegas and win the Ford F-250. We'll get on the outer edges here and just kind of take a look back and so you can see what the events, what's going on, the festivities, the anticipation. It's here and they are ready. They want to see who's doing what and who's going to win. Thank you, sir. We appreciate it. These guys don't just get here and think they have the day off, that's for sure. These tenders are hustling. These masons are sweating, and they're making it happen. This is not a day off for them, that's for sure, folks. Thanks to our spectators for coming out and supporting their teams, their businesses, their family. This is a family event, and we do appreciate everybody coming here to support their folks. We know it's a difficult and trying year, but we're keeping this event going. We're streaming live to you at each one of our events across the United States, and we appreciate everybody out there joining us. My name is James. I'll be here for another hour, hour and a half with you, talking the talk, walking the walk, laying some brick, staying out of their way if I can. And I'll do my best to stay in the edges so that we keep this going on. Shout out to one of our serious, serious workmen. Nice job, Steve. Thank you. Father-son team here getting after it. Looks like to be one of the walls to be competing with. Dad's super proud of his boy, that's for sure. This is what it's about right here, folks. Again, different techniques of laying out the brick for the mason. Again, you can see the use of the twigs and pulling the strings tight. These guys get to one layer, they pull the strings up, the brick sits on the top of the brick to line it up with the next brick, so that as they go down the wall and spread their mud, the bricks stay consistent A lot of you folks out there at home watching wonder why, what's going on, how do they keep that brick so
30
level?
Minutes, 30 minutes, guys.
Some of, their,
we got
some of the tricks
there,
of the trade.
Halfway there. Who's going to be going to Vegas?
As you may or may not hear our announcer, we have 30 more minutes of this event left. 1 hour, folks. 1 hour. And this is what we've got so far on this one wall here for this team. As you can see, they are working it to make it happen. Gotta zoom in here and give you a little NASCAR action as it happens. Again, speed, accuracy, it's all about it. These guys definitely are looking to go to Vegas. We got guys here working the mud for us. We appreciate all the efforts of our mud slingers. Could not do it without these guys. Again, usually these are students, apprentices from various Mason organizations and companies doing their thing. How we doing, Ricardo?
Good.
Looking good, looking good. Ricardo here has been laying brick for about 20 years. Got Oklahoma in the house here. Over here and take a look at some of these walls here again. These guys are getting after it. Not a lot of talking amongst the teams here because they know what they're doing. They've practiced this, they've talked about it, they've rehearsed it. These guys don't just show up and do the job, guys. They think about it, they talk about it, they strategize, they lay out the brick the way that they want to have it, the way they want to pick it up. It's a good angle here of the various styles of brick from one mason to the other. As you can see, keeps his at an angle. Others keep them nice and straight stacked. Nice tall lead wall here, as you can see. As you can see, he's adding a little water to his mortar, cutting it up, adding some moisture and air to it, keeping it fluffy, keeping his mason happy. Good job. Little shout out to a few of our folks here, they're Franklin Cucurillo and the beautiful bride of our regional manager, Trey Harris. Thank you for being here. Keep it in perspective, guys. You can see this gentleman over here has half a brick wall up. No, he's not quitting. He's built one wall up with intents, with coming back and filling it in. He is no stranger to this game. We'll try to get down here and get you a better view of this. Again, this is a one side that he's got going on, and he's popping the string, moving it, and laying up the other side. We'll see how he does and comes back and fills in his leads here, guys. Got his coaching staff here with him. Got his team. We appreciate you guys being here. We are in anticipation for about another 25 minutes to see what these guys come up with in a number of bricks and points. Again, guys, these folks are laying these walls. They're level, they're plumb, they're doing their very best to either win craftsmanship award, first place, second place, third place, all of which cash prizes, levels, Marshalltown masonry bags, a lot of good stuff here online to win. And of course, that infamous trip to Vegas that all of us want to go to. Take another look here at our father-son team. Walls looking nice, guys. People are hustling. They know that we have about 30 more minutes left of this bricklayer event. Again, you can see that he's using his Stabila Level, keeping it plumb, keeping it straight. That's the name of the game. Again, keeping his strings tight, getting ready for his next course. Sweet looking wall. We'll take a close up here. It's D Brown Masonry. We got Whitehead Masonry here, getting after it.
We're trying.
You're doing it. Nice tall lead here. Looks like we got a nice wall in the making. Of course, all of these walls, good looking walls. We appreciate all these competitors, the use of our products, SPEC MIX, the Acme Brick. This is turning out to be one eventful bricklayer. Some serious competitors here. I'm gonna try my best not to distract from them and take away from what they're doing, but looks like we've got some folks that are neck and neck to take this championship. Student teacher team, glad to have these guys here. Take a walk around over here and peek at the walls and just see some of the strategies that you got going on here. Again, single side, coming back, filling in his brick leads. Got 9 courses high right here right now, folks, 9 courses. Again, 80 brick per course.
He just said he's planning on laying 10 courses, that's 800 brick.
800 brick, man, gosh, folks. I don't know that I could lay 800 brick in a week, but these guys are getting after it. So his goal is to shoot for 800. Let's see if we get it plumb. Let's see if we can get no deductions. Let's see what kind of wall we come up with here. Good looking wall, folks. This is what you look for. 1 hour. We're 35 minutes into this, guys. 35 minutes into this. Serious competition. We're looking at some serious temperatures here. It's warm. These guys are sweating. They're not taking any breaks. They're doing whatever it takes to be craftsmen, first, second, or third place winners. Our father-son team here is knocking it out, doing a great job. Nobody's slowing down here. Again, you see some of our masons keeping that wall nice and level, plumb, keeping the strings tight. You'll notice walking around throughout the event here, some of our red shirt SPEC MIX judges. They're here to observe, watch, support, as well as do our brick counts, do our judging for the level, the plumb, making sure everything's done consistently and the same. We appreciate our judges. Let's get back here on the edge of our contest here so we get a better view of what's happening.
Yeah. 30 minutes, guys. 40 minutes. We got 20 minutes left.
again, as you can see, little SPEC MIX BRICKLAYER 500 tapped there. He is not messing around. Says he's not going to take it off until he wins Vegas.
Maybe another year.
We'll walk you around the event here, show you our competitors. It's Trey Harris, one of our regional managers here.
Yes, sir.
Putting on this event. What do you think about this event so far, Trey?
Oh, it's looking good. Got a good, lot of good quality bricklayers here today.
Yep, some good looking walls.
Yes, sir.
We're looking probably roughly around 25 minutes or so left. These guys are starting to feel the strain, the pain. I got this nice looking wall here, as I say, he's filling in the leaves in just nicely. We're gonna come over here and talk to Robert a little bit about some of the rules.
Thanks, James, appreciate it. Like we were saying when we were talking about strategy a little while ago, this right here, let's look here on the wall. This lead, whether it needs to be plumb, it needs to be the right height. It needs to be plumb, it needs to be the right height. So this lead is the right height and is plumb, then all the brick between, all the courses in between will be right. If that isn't right, if it's out of plumb, it's 100, it's too tall, too bad, it's 100 bricks. So we judge the bed joints, the head joints, whether it's whether they have a tip brick, those can be 25, 50 point reductions. And at the very end, a lot of times we'll have tip brick on the top of the wall because guys are hurrying too much. And we had that in Tulsa where numerous tip brick. We didn't have very many deductions for mortar, but for other than height and plumb, we had one out of plumb. But these little bitty things can cost you your whole wall and the whole competition.
Robert, by definition, a tip brick is, what's that again?
It has to be a quarter inch out of the wall or more.
Up or down?
No, a tip brick, yes. Tip brick, quarter inch, past the quarter inch, 25 point deduction. If it's a lip brick, more than 25 quarter inch out of the wall like this, that's a lip brick, that's a 50 brick deduction. So you're wiping out a whole, almost whole course on the one side of the double. So it's real important to get those right. We have a myriad of other ones that has the face has to be out. That's a 50 brick deduction. You can't have any chips more than half an inch. That's another 50 brick deduction. Again, the height has to be within a quarter inch on all these points, each end of the wall in the middle, within a quarter inch. That's 100 brick deduction. If it's out of plumb, that's another deduction. So they can add up and they can add up. So just some of the rules.
Cool. Thank you, Robert. Appreciate that information. Again, you can tell there is a face on the brick and then there is a back of the brick. That's exactly what Robert's talking about. We can't have that. Don't want that. Could cost the whole entire competition for some of the teams. Guys are hustling. Nobody's slowing down. Doing exactly what it takes to win that trip to go to Vegas. Every second counts, folks. So for the most part, when you see these guys hustling and jogging around, they are not doing it for exercise, that's for sure. They're doing it so they can get one more brick laid, because one brick could be the number between going to Vegas and wishing you went to Vegas. Good looking wall here. These guys, even though they're hustling, they have to be extremely careful. They're not allowed to go into other folks' stalls. Got Artisan Masonry here participating. Doing an outstanding job. Tinder's keeping his boards nice and full. Shout out to Gator Boards. These boards keep the mason on the go. There's the mud on the stick. You can see it, these guys are cutting it up, doing the fluff, adding the air and moisture to the mortar, keeping it very workable for the mason. The more workable his mortar is, meaning the fluffy, the air in it, the easier it is for him to do his job in the sense of keeping the wall level, plumb, and keeping those brick going. Again, guys, it looks as though he's putting it on with ease, but it has to be exactly a half inch in mortar. As you can tell, these mortars are half inch. Deductions are made for mortars that are not, as you can tell, everybody is doing the same mortar bed, half inch. Got his supporters here going. Everybody's here to support everybody. Thanks, ladies, gentlemen. Got D. Brown, one of our former winners of our regional events, Vegas competitor. Good use of his Stabila Level here. As we look at some of these walls, as you can tell from our national sponsor Stabila, these guys keep their tools ready and available, keeping the walls plumb, level. Couldn't do it without them. Thank you, Stabila. I want to thank you, the folks, the audience, for clicking on specmix.com or checking us out on Facebook. We appreciate you being here. This event's for you. It's for the masonry industry. And of course, we're here to grow the masonry industry as well. Several events taking place this week. Looking to crown a few champions, take them to Vegas, have a good time, and show off the skills. Guys working hard here. We'll stand back here and just take a little peek at these guys. How we doing, Dad?
Hanging in there, buddy.
Good, good.
Definitely a workout.
It is a workout. Definitely not a day away from work. These guys will do in 1 hour what it would take two or three guys to do in a day, if that. It's a great event. I could take a little time to thank some of our local sponsors, Acme Brick, Adam Supply, UMCA, the TMC. We do appreciate everybody for being here. Appreciate your involvement. As you can see, these walls are up, level, plumb, looks nice. But, you know, a couple of our folks at home watching are wondering, so what's the deal, the smudges on the brick? Well, we don't count that as a deduction as far as smudges on the brick. These guys will get a few minutes to come back here in a minute after they take a little 10-minute break towards the end of our event. After they take their break, they'll come back in here and they'll clean their walls up, fill in any of the voids, meaning like, for example, this right here, you would see that is possibly a void, but these guys come in here, they fill it in, smooth it out, do their best to clean the walls up for a presentation that's really nice. But the mud on the brick does not count as a deduction. We're looking for uniform joints. We're looking for level. We're looking for quantity and craftsmanship. Thank you.
minutes. 50 minutes, guys. We got 10 minutes left.
Wow. 10 more minutes left in this competition, guys. In 40 minutes, this wall has been built. Incredible. We're looking at close to 700, 750 brick there. Nice, level, clean walls are being presented.
Anybody here watching, you got to encourage these guys. We're starting to really catch the heat here.
Getting closer to the end of the bend, you can see these guys do not slow down. In fact, this is the time when these guys start to really hustle and get it done. You may think once this competition's over that the tender gets to sit back and take a break, but that's not true. The tender is allowed to help out his mason in a sense of pointing out voids, pointing out repairs that need to be taking place of the wall before the actual judging takes place. Again, they'll take a little break, come back, tool the wall, smooth out the joints, fix the voids, and present the wall to the judges at the end of the event. The smears of mortar on the brick does not necessarily count as a deduction, because on most jobs, if you were out there in the field, be it a residential or a commercial job, they come back, they clean the mortar with various chemicals, clean the brick, get it looking good, fill in their voids, and the job is done. We'll talk to Robert here a little bit about a couple more little guidelines and rules that they go by.
Well, James was just going over what the importance of what the tender does, and this competition is especially important because the tender has to lay the brick out, he has to lay the mud out correctly, especially since the mason can only stay on one side of the wall. He can't get on this back side of this wall, so he has to overhand that. His tender cannot hand him anything. So in this competition, there's things that don't happen on the job site that are happening in this competition. Not only does he have to lay overhand, which isn't that common anymore, but his tender can't hand him this trowel or a level or anything. So he'd have to run up and down if he's not planned. So that's more rules. If the tender has him something, that's cost. If he crosses over the wall, there's another deduction. So there's a bunch of stuff to keep these quality walls. That's what Spec Mix wants, is a quality, sellable wall in the end. Not just as many brick as you can lay, which it started out as that. So just a little bit more on the rules.
Thank you, Robert. We appreciate that. I want to thank Robert for his commentary on some of the guidelines and the rules that these masons are going by. Robert is certainly no stranger to our emceeing of our events. Let's just stop here and take a peek at the wall. As you can see, we'll just take a minute and watch this mason at work here. Serious competitor to be one of our winners here.
Oh, man. 6-4.
Give you folks at home a little close-up view of what our guys are going on here. And again, folks, this is not a fast-forward recording. This man is laying brick as fast as you are watching it. Keeping his level, watch his wall. We're moving along the wall just as he's moving along the wall, folks, and I'm walking, okay? I'm walking down the wall, and he's laying brick down the wall. Outstanding job. As you can hear, he's got a cheerleader team. He is running, he is hustling, he is doing what it takes to be a champion, and that's exactly what we're looking for. We're going to just walk out of the way here and let these guys just wrap up the last 10 minutes of what they've got going on. You guys not proud of him, are you? Super proud, yeah?
Corriendo, Mario. Corre.
Five minutes.
Vámonos.
Go, man. 5 minutes is what you're hearing in the background, guys, and you can tell everybody's cheering them on. It's 5 minutes left in the event. They're trying to complete as many courses as they can in the last 5 minutes. Every brick counts once they lay that double course. Got some good looking walls, you say, Robert?
Some nice walls.
I would think that we would. I mean, it's been, what, 55 minutes or so, and these guys, man, I'm looking at probably a little over 700 brick over here, maybe, close to it. Nice looking walls, clean. These guys came here to impress, that's for certain.
Four minutes, guys,
so these guys can take a little break. They get about a 10-minute break. They come back, they'll do the tooling of their walls. As you can see, a lot of this looks good. There are a few little voids, but that's where these guys come back and really make these walls shine. They come back, they fill their voids in, they keep their walls nice and level in hopes for craftsmanship award, first place, second place, or third place. Not only is he a teacher, he's a Mason. This guy's representing not only his students, but the masonry world. We are so happy to have you guys here. Robert McKibben and his tender. Again, if you folks have just now joined us, this young man right here is not only just a tender, but he's about to work for the TMC. He's going around, he's instructing teachers on the
three
fundamentals
minutes,
of masonry.
Trials up, 3 minutes.
If the schools don't
guys,
have a masonry
sure
program, his job is about to be to help them get that masonry
watch
program
out,
going and keep
brick
our youth involved in the masonry stop world.
A lot of tip brick.
These guys do not slow down even in the last minutes. Every brick counts. You may have a wall that has 700 brick, but after deductions, it may be 200 brick. Whereas that may not be the number one in quantity, but we're looking for quality as well. My point in saying that is that you may have a wall with 7 leads take the championship in terms of the number of brick, but it doesn't necessarily constitute the winner. It's the one with the level, less deductions, and the best craftsmanship. Keep it going, guys. Looking good. Nice job.
Two minutes, guys.
Take a quick minute to thank you people for joining us live on the internet. This is something that we look forward to doing. The crowd or anticipation of us crowning the winner. They are all curious as to who's going to go to Vegas. Who's going to win the Stabila Level and the cash prizes. Nobody going slow here, that's for sure. We'll keep going with these guys here. We're probably getting really close to the wrapping up of this Dallas Regional Bricklayer event. And we're gonna be real close to seeing who's gonna be our winner.
Just about 1 minute.
We got about 1 minute, Robert tells me, left in this event.
1 minute left.
Cheer them on, folks, cheer them on. Let's do it. There you go. It's the last minute. This is where errors can cost you in the game when they rush, so you'll see these guys are continuing at the pace they've been at. One deduction could cost them the game, and they are doing the job that they need to do to keep in the game.
30 seconds, trowels up.
We're gonna get over here and look at a wall. Trowels are up, which means these guys have to walk off the job for just a few minutes, take a little break. They'll come back and clean it up.
Ten seconds.
Watch
out, tip brick at the top. 10 seconds. Make sure those.
That's about 10 courses, folks. 800 brick you're looking at there in 1 hour. Pretty impressive.
Trowels up, everybody. Congratulations.
Good job, guys. Good job. Fantastic.
You got 10 minutes to rest, and then we'll come back and have 20 minutes to tool the walls. And we'll do some judging before that, and we'll do judging after that. So, guys, get some water, sit down in the shade, rest a minute, grab something.
We're
going to
do a little walking around here and look at some of our local sponsors. Take a peek at some of the walls before they do their tooling. Some of our judges are already getting going. meaning we do know that these guys have to come back, clean their wall, tool it, but this is where we can count the number of brick. You can check for plumbness now. We don't want to keep these guys in anticipation of who the winner may be towards the end of the event. So as you see these guys walking around in the red shirts with levels, various gauges, clipboards, they're doing everything they need to do to judge these walls. It's Bud Johnson here, one of our 30-year teachers, Mason teachers, I would say, a leader in our industry, a good guy. And yeah, I'm doing some special camera effects here, Bob. I'm running around you here. Bud is very instrumental. I couldn't tell you how many students he's had in his program. If you had to throw a number, Bud, on your teaching, how many students have gone through your program?
Probably 1,200.
1,200, folks.
Guess a bit, it's probably 1,200.
Give me some of that, Bud. Good job, I appreciate it. Bud has been very instrumental, not only in the Texas bricklaying events, but the Oklahoma events. He's one of our judges in Vegas. He comes down to South Texas to our event coming up here in another week and a half. And we do just a big shout out to Bud. We appreciate your help, Bud. Thank you very much. Again, our judges checking for plumb with our Stabila Levels, one of our proud sponsors.
Just put a zero.
Carson, our Tulsa representative. Let's just take a little peek at these walls while these guys are getting a little water break. We'll walk you around. Judges doing a little prejudging of the walls. They are definitely no stranger to what they're looking at. Most of our judges are owners of the companies that are not participating, masonry teachers, and overall masonry leaders. Walk over here and take a little quick look at some of our sponsors as well as the equipment that we use on the job every day. Shout out to Sunbelt Rentals for the use of the SkyTrack. Johnny, our local representative. Good job, Johnny. Again, our G7000 gravity silo here, as you can tell, this is what it's about. A couple of our key members for the Dallas market here, Dallas-Fort Worth, representing that is Frank. We got Dalton here. If it wasn't for Dalton, I don't know what these guys would do. He runs around fixing the machine if they go down and when they go down. We appreciate all the effort. Very rare that it happens, am I right? Some of you folks may have noticed in the background some of these Ford pickups sitting around, and these aren't just for show. These are for folks to look at and think about what it is to be driving them, because that is what they drive away with in Vegas. We'll walk over here and take a quick little peek at the Ford F-250, one of the various trucks. A couple of our bags here for the prizes to get. Top Craftsman Award, of course, $500. Our champion, $750. Nice little trophy trowel. Some of our Gatorback boards, of course. And again, the Marshalltown bags, Stabila Levels. I'd like to thank Quikrete, SPEC MIX, our national sponsors, Steel. And we're not talking steel chainsaw, folks. Steel is a proud producer of many stone cutting tools, from cordless to gas operated to cut stone, brick, you name it. Huge, huge in our industry. As our contestants are taking a little break here, we'll just kind of walk around and visit with various people. We've got a lot of interesting vendors here, from Stabila Level to what we call the Mule. We'll go over here and visit with him here in a minute. Again, our student teacher team here. How you guys think you did? It's tough, yeah?
We're here.
Yeah, well, no, nice looking wall. Nice looking wall. We appreciate you guys coming out and doing this. This is it's the first time I've had a teacher student kind of team, and I'm looking forward to seeing what you guys do in our future events.
I know.
come down here and show you some of our sponsors. This little apparatus here known as the mule. Want to tell us a little bit about what you got going on here?
Yeah, what we've got is a product that we've introduced to the masonry business. It's been adapted in other parts of the construction world, but it's a device that takes the weight off of your mason. It helps extend their capabilities of working at longer period of time. So this block's probably in the 50-pound range. So most of us can lift it a few times without too much fatigue, but none of us really lift loads the proper way. So if you're lifting from a, you know, bent knees and that sort of thing, it's really hard to do either way. So what happens is, this is an assist device. It allows you to balance the load, not have to handle the weight of the load. So I'm gonna show you how it works. If I take it down to this block, CMU, press this button, and inside I engage it, I can now take this block.
Unbelievable.
By hand, and I can take it up over my head, up to 11 feet, and I can move it around, and I can position it, okay?
Just with the use of his fingers.
That's it.
Incredible. Technology has definitely caught up.
Yeah, it has caught up. So it's we've adapted this technology to the construction industry in the last couple of years. So it's been accepted out there in a lot of places. So what happens is now you can place it. You press this button on the side, it releases it. Automatically comes up. We've got it set a little low on this one, but now you just move it to the next one. Your mason, go ahead and finish the laying of the one block. Press this button, it grips it, it automatically takes it to a loaded weight, is what we call it.
Prepares their wall so that they can do the final judging. Crown our winner here. You may see some of these walls and you're thinking, wow, you know, this guy, he only laid, you know, four or five levels. But I'm telling you, it boils down to craftsmanship. It boils down to plumb. It boils down to having the correct face brick out, no voids. And that's how we determine our winner. Not by sheer looks of the wall or quantity of the brick. Take a little peek down some of these walls here, as you can see. Our judges are checking measurements along the wall. We take three measurements, one in the middle, at the end, and at the other end. And these guys are ensuring that the tolerance level is within acceptable numbers.
Okay, guys, a couple more minutes, just a couple more minutes, and we're going to get to the two.
Good looking wall. Our judges are wrapping up some of their brick counts in the plumbness. Again, not a whole lot of things that guys can do as far as on the plumb, but at this point, they come back, they tool the walls, and we'll show you exactly what that is as these guys get going on here. And that is where they take the mud, for example, guys, the mortar on the walls. As you can see, you know, this is almost there, doing exactly what he needs to be doing. So he'll get the opportunity here in a minute to come back, finish his wall, tool it, as we call it in our industry. And you'll see one difference to the other here just momentarily after these guys get going off their break. We do appreciate you guys joining in with us, taking the time to sit there with your team, your staff, your owners of your businesses, and or if you just want to know more about the bricklaying industry. So we do appreciate you being here. Shout out to our Dallas, Fort Worth sales representatives for putting on this event. They've done an outstanding job. We look forward to this event every year. Their participation is just huge here. It's a waiting line to get in this thing in most cases. How you think you did, Chief?
I don't know, not. Not too good.
Ah, you got a good looking wall.
We'll have to find out.
Yeah.
What the judges say.
Again, as you can see, this wall, one fine, clean wall. These guys will begin their tooling here momentarily. How far away are we from tooling there?
Just a minute or two. We'll finish doing this part of the judging. During tooling, we'll talk a little bit about some of our sponsors. We really appreciate those guys.
So our masons are getting ready to get back in their booth. We'll give them the ready, set, go, and they'll get to busy on the tooling, doing the final prep of their walls with anticipation of becoming our new regional Dallas-Fort Worth winner and going to Vegas. Let's just see who that is.
Now during tooling, the tender and the mason can get on either side of the wall. The tender can point out any problems, but he still can't touch the wall. He can both get on both sides and have two sets of eyes on it.
So again, this is a team effort. Our tender, he's not allowed to touch the wall, but he is allowed to help the mason point out the imperfections where it needs to be touched up, tooled, voids filled with other mortar. And again, you're going to see a huge difference here. We'll take a quick peek at this wall, for example. And as you can tell, hasn't been tooled yet. Hasn't been cleaned. Voids hadn't been repaired. But we're about to get after it. And you're going to see a huge difference in what a wall looks like. Semi-complete versus complete. Here we go, folks. They are about, we're checking to make sure everybody's got their trowels up, making sure everybody's not across the brick walls. The start line, as we would call it.
All right, guys, start tooling. You got 20 minutes.
Okay, they've got 20 minutes. 20 minutes to do the tooling. It's a team effort again. As you can tell, these gentlemen are going in here and they're tooling it. Getting the joints all nice and smooth. He's breaking out his vertical joints. Again, people at home, this is not rolling in fast. This guy's working this fast. Again, you can see tender's working with him, making sure that he has ample supply of mortar. He'll clean one side of the wall, come to the other side to get it. Should take about 20 minutes. After that's done, you'll see a major, major swing in where the walls look. We're only minutes away from picking our first place, second place, third place winner, along with the Craftsman. And again, folks, Craftsman is the wall with the least amount of deductions. It's clean, crisp, and as the word states, the best Craftsman of our event. Take you over here and watch these guys do a little repair on the wall. You can see he's got his ruler out. And that's not measuring the wall or the brick. He's kind of just pointing at where his mason needs to go next to do a little touch up or tooling or adding some mortar to fix voids. He's not allowed to touch the wall, but he can certainly point it out using whatever method he feels is appropriate. The ruler certainly works out. And again, you can tell this team has practiced before because he's knowing exactly what he's looking for to help his mason clean the wall up to a point of where the craftsmanship is incredible. Again, the larger the wall, the quicker these guys have to work because they have to. How are we looking, Greg? I'm gonna stay in the shade here so that we don't overheat. Apologize for technicalities, folks, here. All right. All right, folks, we are back here live again.
3 minutes, everybody, 3 minutes.
A few technical difficulties here, but we are back live streaming the event, getting close to the end of the tooling. These guys are working very hard to compete for the cleanest wall now, of course. Not that that's a category, but best craftsmanship does count. Again, we'll give you a little look at the after now. As you can see, he's gone through quite a bit of tooling. He's done some areas that he's working on as far as voids. These guys are in their final few minutes of wrapping up the events. We'll take a look at some of our contenders here. Again, a moment ago we showed you this wall before it was tooled, and now you can see a little bit about what it looks like after the fact. Nice looking walls. These guys have approximately 2 more minutes to get this done. And as you can see, this wall made a major transformation from 15 minutes ago. This is where the rubber meets the road in a sense of finishing these walls up, cleaning them up so our judges can come in. As you can see, some serious hustling still being done. Trying to earn his trip to Vegas. You can see, cleaning any voids, smoothing out his joints. A little teamwork here, making sure that he's doing what he has to be doing to help him, his tender secure a trip as well. Now he's taking his wall and he's brushing his joints, he's cleaning up the wall. We'll follow along here in just a minute, show you the difference in terms of what it looks like now. And we'll come around behind him here and we'll see these walls once he's finished brushing it. Keeping his wall nice and clean. It's working it. It is work.
30 seconds, 30.
If it was easy, anybody could do it, right? Anybody could do it if it was easy. Again, you can see how these guys have come in and they've smoothed out their joints. Got them looking good. We'll follow behind him as you've seen this wall. He's come in now. He's smoothed out his joints. He's brushed. He's done his tooling. Major transformation, folks. Again, this is not just a stack the brick with mortar and let's just see what it looks like. This is a finished wall. This is what we're looking for.
Some of the pallets, and we'll restack some of these brick for the stills.
You can again see he's working his way down the wall. Smith's got his wall as clean as he wants to get it.
All right, guys, what's up?
Wrapping up his day.
Congratulations.
All right, guys. Nice walls.
All right, guys, we're ready to go on to second place. The second place is gonna get $750 cash, or $500 cash, and a Besco gift card for $100. They're gonna get a Marshalltown tool bag, they're gonna get a Stabila Level, and they're gonna get a bag from Marshalltown. Oh, yes, we've got our mud boards. Oh, Gatorback, yes. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I'm looking at the Stabila. Anyway, second place goes to RP Masonry install number one, Justin Pierce and Richard Pierce. Right. Congratulations, guys.
Father-son team right there. That's the way to do it. Super proud of this father-son team here. Outstanding job, guys. Outstanding job. Taking our pictures here of these folks' place. Outstanding job, guys. Here, give me a little bit there. Nice job. Nice job, Dad. We appreciate it.
Hey, we're going to need you guys to come back up here, please.
Whoop. What? What can it be?
All right, 527, number second place, but also best craftsman. Congratulations, guys. Congratulations.
Nice job. Again, folks, that goes to show you it's not the tallest or the most bricks that you put down here,
Justin,
but we're talking
Pierce.
Best craftsman.
Congratulations, guys.
Father-son team again, best craftsman.
Get your Marshalltown trial, custom Marshalltown trial bag, some goodies in the bag. You'll get Besco's giving gift certificates, and so is Texas Stucco, $100. Besco gave $150 gift certificate, and you've got, you got the the Stabila Level.
Hey, there's gift certificates from Texas Stucco.
Nice job, guys. Show me that paycheck here.
Congratulations, guys.
Yeah. There we go.
Here we go, another paycheck.
Thank you. This should be a more
again, about to crown our regional champion here of our local Dallas.
Three-time winner for Dallas. Texas. Oh, congratulations. Three-time winner for Dallas. All right, what we've all been waiting. All right, guys, this is what we've all been waiting there for. The guys that are going to go to Vegas for a chance to win $125,000 in gifts and prizes and one of these F-250 pickup trucks, that is going to be Artisan Masonry.
Artisan Masonry, all right.
Mario Landeros and Aldolfo Gonzales Jr. Congratulations, guys. You're going to Vegas.
Nice job, guys. Yeah, go get me some. Nice job.
Yeah, right here.
Artisan Masonry here.
Nope, not here.
One proud papa here, Bobby Gadu. Thank you very much.
Congratulations, guys.
These guys are headed to Vegas. Headed to Vegas.
$750 for winning this regional. Gatorback mud boards. Custom Marshalltown trial.
And these guys are up here with their local representation, Frank. This is Frank Cucurillo and their winning team, Artistry Masonry. Nice job, guys. We will be going to Vegas. There we go.
Good job.
Congratulations.
$750 right here, along with Spilla, Gatorback boards, Marshalltown bag, trowels. Nice job, guys. Nice job.